In this presentation, we will set up a new QuickBooks account, a new QuickBooks file for our payroll project within QuickBooks Online. As we do so, note that this will be specific to our payroll project, and you may want to set up a new QuickBooks file specifically for the payroll project so that you can work through it in a step-by-step fashion along with the instructional videos. To maximize the benefit and minimize the cost, you may not want to set up the company file until we're going to be working with the comprehensive problem. That's when we're going to go step by step in a sequential order through a problem. Until that time, we're going to be looking through the data and going back and forth from the payroll information as we think about the payroll concepts. During that time period, you may want to work with your own company file or with the example file within QuickBooks. We won't have the same numbers in the example file, but it's free to navigate through the example file. Then when it comes time to move to the project, you can purchase the company file and take advantage of any 30-day free discounts or discounts within a time period. Oftentimes QuickBooks will give us some type of discounted period, and you can take advantage of that discounted period by working through the comprehensive problem in a more systematic way, or concentrating it on it during that time period, generally a 30-day time period for that discount. Here, for more accounting information and accounting courses, visit our website at accountinginstruction.info. We are on the Intuit website, so we're on quickbooks.intuit. This is Intuit, the owner website, so quickbooks.intuit.com. And you'll find this screen. We're going to go ahead and see you'll see a 30-day free trial. So there's going to be some type of discount generally whenever you go into QuickBooks. They'll give some type of 30-day trial period. We're going to go into that and say we want that 30-day free trial and see if we could set this up for our project. Now we have different methods or different areas or different kind of services, packages. We have the Simple Start, the Essentials, and the Plus. Typically, you're going to want to have the Plus if you have inventory. So if you're dealing with inventory, you're typically going to want the Plus. This is kind of the full package for most individuals. It'll cover most companies in the Plus section. If you don't have inventory, however, you may be okay if you're still doing full service bookkeeping, but you don't need to track the inventory or track projects down here, then you may be okay with the Essentials. If you start with the Essentials and you want to later move to the Plus, that's typically okay. You can typically do that. If you go from QuickBooks Online to QuickBooks Desktop, on the other hand, that's a little bit more cumbersome. That's a little bit more difficult. But if you go from a simpler plan within QuickBooks Online to a more expensive plan, QuickBooks will typically make that process not too difficult. So we can upgrade in that method. And then we have, of course, the Simple Start, which if you're doing full service bookkeeping, if you're doing the bookkeeping and tracking the bills, you can see tracking the bills and having multiple users, then you probably are going to need at least the Essentials. However, we here are just going to be dealing with the payroll. So all we really want to do is the payroll and focus in on that. We're actually going to eliminate everything else so that it doesn't confuse us from the payroll. And therefore we get to see the financial statements being generated just with the payroll, focusing in on those accounts being generated as we process payroll. So we're going to go actually with the Simple Start. Again, probably not what most people will need. If you're going to be using this account for your main business, you're probably going to need the Essentials or the Plus. But if you're just working this for the project and you want to go through the project, then we really only need the Simple Start, because no matter which one of these we use, we'll have to tack on the payroll. And you can see there's two payroll options down here. So payroll, you can think of it as kind of like a plugin, but it's a separate thing, although it's through QuickBooks. So it's not like it's another company, but it's going to be an added on. It's going to be a purchase up that you'll have to do. So you have to purchase the QuickBooks and then add on to it the purchase of the payroll. To do that, we would select this item. Now we're going to have the self-service payroll, and that's going to be enough for us to process payroll. The full service of payroll, QuickBooks gives more guarantees about payroll. We'll talk a little bit more about that later, but they're both paid versions of payroll that will help us to process the payroll. We're going to start off with the self-service payroll so that we can manually input that, because our point here is to learn payroll, not to basically have QuickBooks do it for us. So, and QuickBooks, if we do the full service, QuickBooks gives, of course, more support and more assurance. The process is the same between the two. We just typically have more support and help and guarantees. Again, we'll talk more about that process later. So if you want to check on this item as you purchase, then you can go through and get the full discount on the payroll as well as the simple start, and that'll be enough for us to go through and start working through this problem. Once we set up payroll, or if you already have QuickBooks set up, we'll actually go through the setup process. So we're going to go through this process as if we're going to purchase it without the payroll right now, and then we'll add the payroll. To get the best discount, however, you may want to add the payroll right now and then purchase it and get the best discount you can. And then we'll use that paid payroll process as we learn and go through the entering of the data. As you set up the QuickBooks file, we will need the company name. We'll need some minimal information in order to set up QuickBooks Online. We're going to call our company file just simply S Corp Paid Payroll. Now, if you're not an S corporation, that's okay. You can be a sole proprietor or some other format. The payroll functions will remain much the same, although there may be some different items that an S Corp may have that we'll talk about, we'll add on to in addition to possibly what might be there for a sole proprietor. So we're really thinking about a single member type of S Corp, a small type of S Corp when we set up an S corporation. But this is just the name that we're going to be indicating here, not indicating the tax status in a formal sense. It's just going to be called the S corporation paid payroll for our practice problem. We're not going to be adding any data from the desktop, so we don't have any desktop data file that we need to convert for this problem. Then we'll see a screen such as this. We're going to say all set at the end of this screen, and then our file will be set up for us. So the minimal information, that's all we need for basically the minimal information to get our file set up for us, and QuickBooks is good to go from here. For more accounting information and accounting courses, visit our website at accountinginstruction.info.